want to think about being held accountable to God for their actions. Not only because they love sin and they don't want to part with it, but because once they accept that they're held accountable to God for their actions, then they must accept the reality of God's punishment for sin. Hell is real. They come in the second place to the reason for God's hell. Why is there a hell? Why has this glorious, merciful, loving, compassionate, tender, almighty God prepared a place called hell? Our text provides us with the answer. It's wound up in that word punishment. These shall go away into everlasting punishment. There is a hell because there is an absolute necessity for punishment. Christ's teaching here is, he put the words into its context, that because of the deeds, both of those committed and those omitted by these sinners, that there is a hell, and this group of people have to be punished because of their deeds. But what is it that necessitates such an awful place as hell? You see, men really don't want to hear about hell, and they want to make it the brunt of jokes. They want to make the devil to be a little horned figure with a pitchfork, because they don't want to hear that their sin one day is going to be punished in such a way that, I want to tell you, defies description. It defies description.